Dirty bench means one thing, and that's the Viggen. So continuing with this beautiful 32nd scale Viggen build. Again, this is a Jetmads kit. You can't buy it anymore, it's discontinued. I managed to get it a couple of years ago, and we're going with this beautiful one right here with the purple tail. So last week we did the down and dirty, main, a lot of sanding and filling, getting the main kind of fuselage together. This week we continued that, adding some to the 3D printed parts, the lumps and bumps, and various other parts. So let's go ahead and get started. Welcome back. Hope you had a great week and this beast is starting to come alive. So since last week I put the canards on, again I had a bit of a seam issue, gap stuff to take care of. So just where you cut these from the block basically, if you're not slightly off you can get a gap. So same thing, filled the gap with the epoxy, it came back with my filler and then sanded it back, and we should be in good shape. So definitely getting a big heavy lump and looking like a Viggen, and very happy with this. So next up is one of the worst things modeling for me, least enjoyable, is rescribing. So down the side here you can see we took away all the detail, well maybe not the camera, but anyway, we basically sanded, we took obliterated detail, so we need to come back in and scribe it all back in, put the rivets back in, and once that's done, I'm going to hit all the seams with my Mr. Surfacer 1500 Black Primer, and then just shoot the seams, and then we can see exactly how we're looking with some primer over it. It's not going to be perfect, I'm sure there's going to be spaces, what areas we need to go back and redo and sand and stuff, but that's the whole point of doing that. So seam check, and I'm hoping that the main kind of dusty, dirty, heavy duty sanding and stuff is all behind us, and it's just gonna be a few little touch-ups here and there, fingers crossed, because I'm definitely getting a little bit bored of filling and sanding. So yeah, so let me go ahead and spend the boring task of putting the lines back in and getting the thing sprayed, and we'll come back and we'll take a look and see how we're doing. Right, so put down a primer last night, and seems from a distance it actually looks really good. When you're close up, you can see there's definitely some more work required. Like if you see the seam right here, that's not up to kind of level I would expect. And back there, actually not too bad. Underneath isn't too bad. Again, like back here, you can see that. That all needs to be taken care of. So unfortunately, it's not a little bit bummed because I thought it a little better than it was, but it just involves more filling and more sanding. So all these lumps and bumps and stuff just need more filler. Sand it back down and get that thing smooth underneath there too. You can see, again, you can see it's not smooth enough. So the whole point we do primer here is just take care of this. So exactly what we did. And I've noticed here too, there's like a little, see there's a little on top here, little indentation. So again, all needs to be filled and taken care of. So not major surgery, but just, you know, spot checking and taking areas at a time. So not something I particularly enjoy. I'm definitely looking forward to getting past the stage and some more exciting stuff, but necessary part of modeling nonetheless. So I'm gonna work my way through the next few days and take care of spot at a time, a little part of time, filling, sanding, getting them nice and smooth, spray it with primer again, and hopefully we're in better shape. But you know, from a foot away like there, it looks pretty good. It's just, again, if you look close, you can obviously see the imperfections, which aren't gonna fit for a kit of this stature. I definitely want to take care of. Okay, so we're back and been working plenty of sanding here and several doses of filling and sanding, really mostly using this stuff, the 320 grit I got from Home Depot or Lowe's, I can't remember which place I got it from, but this actually works really good. Cut little slices off and just sand away, and yeah, so it's been like a couple of weeks of pretty much doing that, to be honest with you. Obviously not full on, I'm not being the bench every day, but three or four rounds, and hopefully, you know, we're looking better. It looks a little gnarly right now, obviously, because, you know, once it's painted, it should look a lot better. So we've got canards on, looking good, and all sanded, and seams taken care of. So I think next part, well, actually, before we do that, I forgot to mention, I actually did get this in the mail a couple of weeks ago, and I've got my mask set. So this is what it looks like. Big, giant sheets of mask from Maestro Models, and this isn't cheap. This was about $45 US dollars shipped to the US, but here's my cheat sheets So when we get to the painting stage, we'll go through this and make things a lot easier than having to mask all this crazy pattern. So pretty much essential. So again, Maestro models, big, long, skinny piece of paper. I guess that's some kind of European size because it's unusual. Anyway, we're going off track here. So next up, we're going to add all these lumps and bumps and stuff, I think. So going back in the instructions now, the section 16, page number 8, you can see, if I hold it a little closer here, all these guys, like little bumps go on here. Little tiny ones we're not going to worry about, I think, because they're going to break off. And there's definitely a few more things down here too. Oh, we've got all the pylons to go on. And that'll probably keep us going for a little bit. So I'm going to start. Lucky thing with these guys are I'm finding the 3D printer stuff fits pretty good. The cast resin, like this color stuff, like all these pylons and stuff, aren't the best to fit. Now, it's partly this, and it might be my own fault too, the way I, you know, cutting off the blocks and stuff might be not quite getting it right, sanding maybe too much, but generally it's not, this doesn't fit great. So I'm fully expect every one of these underneath will need some kind of filling and some work doing to it. But the 3D printer stuff, fingers crossed, has been fitting pretty good. The grayer plastic, the bluey gray, reach over here, like this color stuff. Obviously this bit goes in the front here. Cool, so enough waffling, let me get on, start cutting these up and crack on with this, get them glued on and I'll be right back. Okay, so got those four parts on. Again, as I talk for this build, the numbers don't really match up and it's, you're kind of picking and choosing what you're doing here, but basically you want the flat side along the bottom and a part that slopes in kind of goes away from the aircraft. That makes sense. You can see where I've done there, and these two match up with like the line that goes around. So if I hold it kind of close to the camera, hopefully these four you can see. And again, just use all epoxy. You know, we talked about this stuff in previous parts. The 5-minute stuff, working really great. Bob Smith's 5-minute epoxy. Just mix 50-50 and glue these down. It gets really strong once it, you know, once it goes off. So it's always put it off. Okay, I'll prop it like, ooh, okay. Let me put it like out of the way a little bit. Okay, put it here. So next up, we've got this guy. Now, I'm sorry, I don't know what this is. Some kind of weapon system, I'm guessing. So, sensor or something. So, this part doesn't fit very good on the underside. So, you see with my old sprue cutters, I just clipped a chunk off the back, about 3 mil. Just roughly cut on the bottom so it fits in a slot better. Otherwise, it just doesn't fit. It's just not quite angled. Also, this area here is resin. You have to cut it away. So with my knife, I just scored it away, snapped it away, and sanded it back. Moved this section here because we're going to glue in this guy, which sits like that. So also, this little attachment point, I cut back a couple of mil too. It's because we have another part that goes on, and again, didn't fit very good. So bringing my epoxy in, and just going to smear it on the area, and again, it's 5-minute epoxy, so it's going to take 5 minutes to go off. So I think we're in a good position there. Actually, it's kind of slipping a little. Maybe it's better that way. Okay, like that. So I'm just going to leave that. Fuel tank has this little guy, 3D printer part that goes in to kind of join the two parts together. So again, more epoxy. Stick this little guy like that, with the connector, and then with the rest of the epoxy, I'm gonna run around. Okay, so that's that guy done. This piece right here goes in this slot at the back, like that. And then this piece will fit up on here, but obviously I want to wait for this to dry and have to make another batch up. So put that guy down, and what I'm basically going to do is for the next few minutes, I'm just going to hold this tight so it sets and it gets straight. And that's the wall of the epoxy. So I'm going to hold this once it's dried, and 5 minutes, then you can leave it a few hours or overnight to fully cure. And then check on this guy too, this is still lined up.
we're good on this too. So, okay,
let these dry and I'll be right back. All right, just a quick update. Got these guys on, actually fit really good. Now, if you see here, I want to show you what I'm doing, my clips here. So a couple of clothes pegs hold it down because you need to get this to kind of bend to go with the contours of the wing. And if not, you can have a significant gap. So got this on, it's dry by now, but just hold it down so it's flush. And I'll do the same on the other side. These two guys, if you forget which one, they should be kind of level pretty much. If you put them the other way around, one's longer than the other. And that is really it. I just want to show you the one side. So it did fit really nicely actually thus far. Again, I just want to make sure my epoxy wasn't gluing my clip on. But I just want to make sure you getting them on using the clips and get it so it's contours with the wing and we're looking good. Alrighty, so got this guy glued on, got these guys glued on, and the other side obviously, and we're good to go. And definitely using those pegs to help it, force it in and go to the curvature of the wing there. Also realized going back from the instructions, I forgot these two big guys. So put these in, just need a little bit of sanding because they're a little bit too high. And even now I think just needs a little bit more sanding now it's dry just to kind of blend it in a little bit. So these two went in no problem at all. Typically I'm finding with the 3D printed stuff, it fits really well. A little bit of a gap here and just need to take care of. And maybe around here, I don't know. But there we go. So you see it's taking shape now. And that's kind of where we're at. It's kind of hard to position it now, know where to put things, but I'm keeping the box on the phone. And as you can see by magic here, well, not only have I got epoxy all over my nice cutting mat here, but I put these guys on too. And to be honest, looking at the instructions, I was a little bit overwhelmed to start with. I thought, oh my God, it's going to take me forever, but it literally just took a couple of minutes. And once again, just epoxying it all on to make sure it's a really strong. I think the epoxy has something like a 1,500 pound, I think it says on here, 3,500 PSI non-brittle bond. So there you go, you can't get much stronger than that, right? So again, as always, you see I put masking tape on with a number so I know which one's which. So we got some couple of canards done there, and we got the rudder, and these are the canards, and these are the flaps, like that. Now, if I bring the instructions in, find the correct page for you, you can see down along here and up is the top line. So using ones at the bottom, so I'm obviously having to whip the flaps down. So I'm all followed instructions. So you see, for example, on F1, you see 22, 23, and 24, because I'm down. If you're going up, you'll be using C12, 13, or 14 instead. And then we're just gonna basically place those canards on. Now I did have a, the rudder, again, you got three parts. If you wanna go neutral, left or right, I'm going left, so I use part number C40, and just test fitting it, it didn't quite fit very good, so a little bit of sanding would be needed there. But again, all these little lights, clear parts, and these little bumps and stuff, we'll probably leave those off till the end, so they're going to snap off. But yeah, we're in good shape, so I'm going for instructions here. A lot of this is cream crossed off already, and also you need to go back and do the cockpit, the front section. So let me go ahead and get all these glued on now, and I'll come right back. Right, so we're done with this part, as far as I can go with this section. So as you see, we've got the flaps on, the canards are on, the flaps in the down position because it's powered down, the rudder's on, underneath, we've got some more parts and stuff added. Just moving this is not quite flush. There we go, let's bend it back in the shape. And we're in good shape, it's looking really good. I'm very happy with this, but a lot of work gone into it. These flaps, I think easiest, just put the epoxy on, let it sit for about 5 minutes. Actually, I timed it, it's about 8 minutes till it went off. So leave it for 5 minutes, just sat on a bench, come back, and then last couple of minutes, when it hits about the 4.5 minute mark, just hold it for like 2 minutes into place, and literally hold it there for like, I don't know, 3 or 4 minutes until about that 8 minute mark. And then I found I can let go, and it's kind of bound. And now this is tough as nails. I mean, this isn't going anywhere. Now, my normal videos you watch with plastic kits, I don't put all this stuff on right now. I paint it all first generally and put it on later because it just snaps off. But the fact I'm using this epoxy with 3,500 PSI of non-brittle bond, I think we're in pretty good shape. I don't think it's going anywhere. It's going to be, unless you drop it or whatever. But my challenge now is it's kind of hard to know where to put it. I think I have to put on some foam so I don't break anything. So there we are, beast. Also weighed it. I remember a week or two ago I actually weighed it and said it was like 5 ounces or something. My scales are broke, so I reset my scales and I just weighed it right now. It's just over a pound, which or about half a kilo is what it weighs. It does weigh a little bit more. Feels like to me it's a lot more than that, but I guess that's what it is. So yeah, looking good. I seen already there's some problems down there with these more filling down here. It looks a little gnarly. So definitely some more work needing some more places here and there. But generally really happy I was going to get it. The main bulk of it is done now. There's not a lot of parts left in that box. We've got basically the gear left to do, and the front section here, which is basically the cockpit tub and the nose cone. So next week, I'm not sure which of those I'm going to do. We'll see how I'm feeling, if I'm going to do the gears or the cockpit tub. We'll do one or the other. I have cut the wheels off already, and the wheels do look very nice. Obviously 3D printed and no seam lines or anything like that. But again, you know, this thin little... they say it does, but it doesn't. For me, it looks a little skinny, and to hold that half a kilo weight, you know, on these, I don't know. We'll see over time. But nevertheless, looking fantastic. Really liking this one. A lot of work's going into it, but really happy how it's turning out. And hopefully enjoying this one too. It's a little bit something different to usual. So have a great week as always, and I'll be back next time with my next part.